Tonight, we'll be having the wife of Gregory Isaacs join us, June Isaacs. We'll also be having... Hey, June! What's up?
I'm good.
Ah, so nice to have you. June, you're beautiful.
Thank you. I was having some problems.
And yeah, I guess so. You probably didn't unmute your mic.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry about the inconvenience, but I'm here. I'm finally
nice,
here.
Nice to know that.
Welcome, June Star. You're listening to Benji on the Classic
FM. Hi, Benji. 7.3. How are you? 3.
I'm doing well, June. Incidentally, both of you bear June. I don't know. What's the love for June? I mean, both of you, June Hayles. June, by the way, you are Bob Marley's cousin. Yeah?
Yes, I am. His mother and my grandmother are 2 sisters.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. I mean, it must have been quite a loss when you heard that he died.
Yeah, you know, that's a big loss for the family because, you know, I wouldn't want to know what the world would be like today if Bob was still alive because of the work that he has done in such a short time and the milestone that he had reached in his career. I think if anyhow he was around today, the world would be a better place.
Exactly. And then he was so philosophical with his song.
Yes, he was like a godsend. He was godsend. Yeah, he was a real man of God because when you listen to his lyrics, right now, even the pastors in the church are quoting lines from his songs.
I know. Well, June Hayles, so nice to have you. But Isaacs, you've been married. Take us, you know, to the beginning. When you were young and Gregory was hot, you're hot as well, and you met each other, you know. So quickly take us through that part. What was it like back in
Benji,
the day?
Benji, you're putting me on the spot right now.
I should put you on the spot.
Okay. In the early 80s, I met him. No. Yeah, early 80s. When I met him during my time living on campus at college, Teachers College in Kingston. I'm a country girl. Mm. Way in the country, deep country girl. Coming from a Christian family and all that, ended up in college in the city.
Hi.
As a country girl, you know, on the weekends, you venture out to see new things, meet new people, new etc. So on this weekend, we had gone to Randy's record store.
Yeah.
Downtown. Because, you know, up on a weekend, you go, collect your little CDs. At that time it was cassettes. Just to keep you occupied and keep you away from the lesson sometimes you play music. And to be, let me tell you, Randy's record would now be VP Records in New York. Have you heard about VP Records?
No, I've not.
Oh, it's a big distributor in New York.
Reggae distributor in New York.
Right. But it was in downtown Kingston. You know, as a young girl, your family warned you and all kind of things about men in the city, about rest of men in particular. But this particular day, I was downtown and this rasta man, nicely dressed, a dapper looking
and
guy.
And you fell for him.
Exactly.
Oh my God.
I love that.
You know, he came to us in such a quiet, unlike the typical rasta men, he was so calm and he whispered in my ear and I was so frightened. I was so scared because we said, Lord Jesus, rasta man and all, long tone. And then, but he was persistent in speaking to me and I was there hardly answering him because I was more scared than anything.
No, but was it big? Yeah? Was it big then? Yeah, I mean, has he started his musical thing? And
actually, he had a song, Love Is Overdue, that I used to play earlier on, but I didn't know it was him.
Oh.
Yeah, I didn't know who he was. I didn't even have a clue. He was just there and I was just being calm and nice. and he was just talking alone, and I wasn't even answering him until he asked us where we were from. It was my girlfriend and myself.
Ah.
And I said, we're students at Chartered Teachers College, and he offered us a ride. And we said, no, we're not taking a ride from stranger. We're afraid like hell. So, I don't know, because we told him the location we were going, he knew that we were going to take the bus back, so he drove behind the bus. And when we reached the college campus to come off the bus, who we see behind the bus? Same gentleman.
Gregory Isaacs.
So we run. We run across the play field until we reach on campus. We say, all right, now we're safe. And we tell others about what happened. To my surprise, the man drove in the college. And from there, we had conversations because I am on safe ground now.
Yeah.
We had conversations, and then he started visiting us. And all the time, we never even know who he was.
So how did you find out? When did you get to know?
Probably 2 weeks, about 2 weeks after. When
everything connect.
The song came up, Love Is Overdue Again. And I said, but not that song we used to play a country pun jukebox. And I said, oh my God, look where I am now in the presence of the same man. Anyway, he visited me every day at college, every day. Until we became friends, until...
But I'm sure you were more than friends. I mean, couldn't have been just ordinary friends.
Well, we were still friends for a while. We were friends for a long while before anything happened. Because as I said before, I was still scared. I wouldn't venture off with anyone like that off campus. But anyway, we became friends, and the rest is history.
All right.
I'm going to have a short time with you guys. As you know, I have a commitment.
You have commitment. So, yes, let me quickly take you. Let me take
Because I will still have to leave. Yeah.
I mean, you have known Bob Marley from while all of you were small.
Yeah.
What was it like growing up with Bob Marley? Did you know he was going to end up being the Bob Marley that everyone in the world knows?
Well, I was a child living in 9 Mile in St. Anne, where he was born. And as a little girl growing up there, he used to come to country when he was living in Kingston, him and Mrs. Marley. And we know that Bob is our family member, and we look up to him because when he come to country, you know, everybody know that your pot is going to go on the fire because this man like, when him come to country, it's like Reggae Sunfest or Reggae Sunsplash, because everybody come out to see this man. And we know that he was like this good Samaritan. And whenever I have like school trips, because I was he called me the little black one that loved the books. So whenever my school books to be bought, I have to go to Hope Road and collect the money from Diane Jobson. And like when I have to go on school trip, my money first pay, because he always pay a lot of attention to me because he see that I'm the one who loved the book. But Bob was like phenomenon. Bob is, he cannot be duplicated. You can't find words to talk about him, because even up to today, you can see the reaction, the generation to generation. This is one man that everybody, the whole world, when you go anywhere, everybody from them see the Jamaica passport, you are from the Bob Marley country. You are not from Jamaica, but you are from the Bob Marley
country. Exactly.
So he made his name. We love him, we adore him, and even in death, we cannot stop talking about him. But he's a legend, he's an icon. There's no word in my vocabulary. I can't find nothing to describe Bob Marley.
June, at a point he became a bit controversial when he started being philosophical, and then looking at using music as a tool to discuss social ills, especially for the Western world.
Yes.
At that point, were you guys afraid for his life?
Well, we know to speak the truth, you know, the truth is an offense, but it is not a sin. And somebody have to come and talk the truth, because people need to know the real truth about life. And in his songs, Until the Philosophy Which Hold One Race Superior and Another. Songs like those, Think You Are in Heaven and You're Living in Hell. You know, Rasta Man Live Up. We have to fight for our rights. all of those songs are songs that Bob Marley sings that right now, all of those lyrics, you can see it in today's life. Mm. So he would have to speak the truth and he speak it in his music. Mm.
Now, another thing, let me quickly ask you this before I let you go.
Yeah.
I do know that racism used to be a big issue then, back in the day. And Bob Marley was one who used his music to liberate the black race, kind of, if I can say that. Because there's so much of freedom, human rights, messages in his music. Looking back and looking at what we have today, what do you think about racism? Imagine if Bob Marley is still alive. Do you think he would have further pushed the fight against racism?
Well, racism, it is obvious up to today. From for our forefathers, we have been brutalized. Black, Ziggy sing a song, Black is my story. Mm. Bob, don't look at colors, creed or class. Black from, I have been working in a field right now where I work with the white, I work with the black because of colors, but I don't see none of my patients as who is black or who is white. If you stick me, blood come from me
and
with a
color,
black skin.
Red
and
color,
if you
yeah.
stick the white person, blood come from the white person just the same. So that is exactly what Bob is saying. One love, one heart. Let's get together and feel all right. We don't look at who is black from who is white. We are just one people made by God. So racism is active right now, and he would be still preaching the same message if he was alive, that we should all live as one. No black, no white.
He'd be breaking more barriers.
No, the break barriers, everything. Everybody is just the same. We are all one human being made by God.
By God. Isaacs, you wanted to react to something. June Isaacs, you were saying something.
No, I was saying that if he was here, he'd be breaking more barriers. More barriers.
Exactly, he would have broken more barriers.
Yeah.
June Hayles, I'm wondering. I mean, Bob Marley left so much in the sands of time. No one can fill his shoes. But is there a possibility of maybe some of the foundations that he left behind? Is the family looking at taking some of these foundations to another level? I mean, probably share it across the world, globally, the continent of Africa. Are you guys thinking in that direction?
Well, if it is thy will, it must be done. And I know the Marleys have contributed significantly. Sometimes they don't like to be in the public, but I know they have done a lot for people over the whole world. I know that for sure. In Jamaica, in Africa, Mrs. Marley has done a lot that I know of. Mm. So if it is thy will, it must be done. We will not stop. We will take the message of Bob Marley. We will do what we can do that is in our powers to help who we can help, when we can help, and how we can help. We have no problem with that.
Okay, quickly, this last one, then we'll let you go. Bob Marley left behind so many children. When I say children, biological and non-biological, in terms of music and all of that. The biological kids, Bob Marley, they're doing very well musically. What's your relationship with them? Are you guys good?
Well, all of my cousins, Ziggy, Steve, Damien, Sidella, Kimani, all of them, we are one big happy family.
Yeah.
I have no problem with my family. I just love to see how they embrace each other and what they are doing to carry on Bob's legacy. They are a beam, an icon. These kids are so talented. They are working so hard. And sometimes it grieves me when I hear people say that it's because it's Bob Marley's children why they excel and they evolve and they reach this and that. They have their ability to do what they have to do. Sometimes I hear people say, oh, from one of the Marleys is in the Grammy nominated, they will get the Grammy. It don't go like that.
Yeah.
They put the work out, their work is professional, and they carry the message of their father. And that is the reason why they are achieving their goal. Their hearts are clean, and I will stand up for them anywhere, anytime, anyhow. I love my family, them, and I adore them. And all I can say, people have to do, you know, I got tired to see them face.
All right, this is Classic FM 97.3. My name is Benji, and I'm...
Before I go, I want to big up Bronco and the Roaring Thunder International.
Roaring Fime, Thunder.
Kilimanjaro Entertainment in Nigeria.
Kilimanjaro. These are my guys, man.
I want to big up everybody down there, and I will be there, me and June, shortly to do some logistics on the ground for the events that we're going to be doing next year, 2022. Want the whole Nigeria to know that we have a blessing and we have a back. And right now, I have an assignment that I have to take on. But you just take care of yourself, people, and I love you, and bye.
Blessings. Yeah, I want to thank you so very much.
Big up, Rasta.
I love that. If you've joined us, my name is Benji, and this is Classic FM 973. Yeah. I have with me Gregory Isaacs' wife, June Isaacs, and June. Thank you so much, June Hayles. June Hayles is Bob Marley's cousin. You just heard from her. June Isaacs, let's take a song. Take a song by Bob Marley, and then I'm going to come back to you. You have taken me, you know, a little bit back to how you and Gregory Isaacs started. And then after all of that, it's love. And you said the rest is history. We're going to visit that history when we come back, you know, because I want to know.
Okay.
All right. Let's do a song by Bob Marley, and this is One Love. You think that's fine?
That's fine,
yeah? All right, here is Bob Marley and the Wailers, and One Love. Classic FM 973, we are the station and only station that plays every song you know. My name is Benji, and joining me tonight, two great ladies. One has been in the life of Gregory Isaacs all through, all right? The wife, June Isaacs. And of course, we just had June Hayles, Bob Marley's cousin, both of them joining me in the studios. June Isaacs, I mean, you took us around how it all started with Gregory Isaacs, all right? But in between all of that, where is the role of June and Cool June? How did Cool June
After graduating from college, which was 2 years after, I ended up living with him. We became man and wife. Man and woman, not wife yet. And about 2 years after, on my birthday.
When exactly was this? When did you guys get married?
I'm going to tell you. 1983, December the 1st.
So
now, my birthday, although I named June, my birthday is the 28th of November.
Two or three days apart.
Okay, so my birthday, he woke up in the morning and he said, "I have the best gift for you." And I said, "What is that?" And halfway through the day, I'm looking to see if anything is going to deliver or anything I wanted, you know, anticipating what's going to happen next. Because midday come, nothing. So then he said to me, "I'm going to make you my wife. So I laughed and he said, "Yes, serious."
So apparently you didn't believe it?
No, I didn't believe.
Why? I mean, you guys have been dating.
Just the way he said it and how sudden it was, I just wasn't taking that. So he said, "I'm going out to get the rings." And I said, "Wow, you go and find a church," which was me. He's telling me to go get a church for the same day for us to tie the knot. But that was totally impossible. We couldn't get the church quick enough. And all of that even was coming now, and you know, time was going, so the arrangement we made was for 2 days after, or 3 days after, which was the 1st of December. So I got married on that date, 1st of December, 1983.
Wow. And then both of you stayed together for that long. How was it easy or challenging managing someone with all of the stardom? I mean, he was someone who was moving from one place to the other, playing at one gig,
I was always with him. Anybody will tell you, I was always, he didn't leave me anywhere. It was a bit challenging because then I wasn't used to girls all over him and all of that thing. So just kind of challenging, but I got accustomed after a few years and being tutored that it's only about the show. It's only about the songs. It's only about him for the moment. Mm. I mean, once he's home, he's with me. So why bother?
Yeah.
Why, you know? Mm. Anyway, it was nice. We traveled all over. Mm. I mean, performances were very good.
Yeah. Very good. Let me ask this. When you met Gregory Isaacs, he started singing and all of that, doing songs, but he wasn't as big as we know Gregory Isaacs to be.
No.
Now, what song would you consider his biggest? His biggest?
Night Nurse. Night Nurse for sure.
Night Nurse.
And that's how I met Junie. Because we were both downtown. She was working with Bob Marley at the pressing plant.
Yeah.
We had Night Nurse running the press like crazy. Mm. So I had to go to her for anything extra, any extra time or anything like that. So that's how I met her. Because we didn't have hands to sell Night Nurse when it came out.
Now, was it the same song that gave him his first international breakthrough?
I wouldn't say that. I think...
Because that was Cool Down the Pace. There was
all of those were on the same album, but I think he had Front Door before that, and Number One. All those songs were leading up to the big song Night Nurse with the big international fame, because by then he had signed with Island Records.
All right.
Yeah.
Let me surprise you. I have a song by Gregory Isaacs, and I'd like to play this song right now.
Go ahead.
You know what? I won't tell you the title of this song, but you just mentioned it, but I still won't tell you. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Okay, Benji.
All right. This is Gregory Isaacs.
Okay.
And the title is... You want me to say it? You want me to tell you?
Yes.
No, sorry. I won't tell you. I won't. All right, anyway, this is Number One. All right, Classic FM 97.3, Gregory Isaacs, and my Number One. Tonight on the very best of, I want to say very, very best of jazz. My name is Benji. It is Remember the Time. It's a very special one. We've got with us in the studios, Gregory Isaacs' wife, June Isaacs. We also have had June Hayles, Bob Marley's cousin. Now, that song, I mean, was done between 1977, 78 or thereabout.
Right.
Yeah.
Around about that time, yeah.
Exactly. And he did it alongside Alvin Rangling.
Ernest Rangling, yeah.
Exactly. There was also this, is it Birda?
Miss?
Birda, another song.
Border. Yes. Exactly. If I could reach the border, I'd step across. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. Now, Gregory Isaacs is one of the biggest exports from Jamaica. I mean, he's moved everywhere in the world, from the US, the UK. He's gone almost everywhere in the world. And then as he moved, as he traversed the entire globe, he left foundations, he left legacies behind. Now, what are you doing to ensure that these legacies, don't die?
Well, we started a foundation for Gregory a year after he passed, which we call the Gregory Isaacs Foundation.
Hmm.
And Gregor was very kind. He was always giving, and mostly to kids, mostly to preschool and basic schools. And so we started on that trend to provide schools with supplies, food, uniform, etc. to these kids. And out of that, we build until we have a massive foundation right now, where we just give back.
All right. Yeah?
Yeah. We, it's Evie's first school that he attended. We have totally adopted that school, and we have been working wonders there as it relates to education.
Now, I don't know how I can ask this without breaking a tear, but can you just recall some of the fondest memories with Gregory Isaac?
There's too many. Too many, Benji, too many. Anybody will tell you that Gregory's a comedian.
Oh, I didn't know that.
He'll keep you on your toes. He is a comedian. Ooh. He will make you laugh from here to there. So everyone enjoys going on tour with him, because once you're on the tour bus, you're cracking up all the way. So just imagine him at home. A strict father anyway, with 10 kids at home. Very strict dad. But if he find time to play with the kids, he find time to have fun, he find time to sit with them with schoolwork. When it was time for chores, he set that standard. And we had a duty list, and he was on the duty list as well, so he had his day to do whatever. So everybody followed it, that. School was very important for him, education rather. So
let me ask this. As at the time that Gregory Isaacs was, making real cool music and, making cool cash, Bob Marley was also doing that. What was the relationship between Gregory Isaacs and Bob Marley?
Okay, I wasn't a part of that, because shortly after I met Gregory, Bob passed. I just remember his funeral. I know him and Dennis Brown is very close, like blood brothers. But Bob, I cannot. I wasn't a part of that, because I wasn't before that day.
Would you consider Gregory Isaac's genre of reggae to be lover's rock? I've always said that he pioneered, himself and Dennis Brown pioneered lover's rock. Is that right?
Well, that's how they call it. They dub him. They dub him as a lover's rock man.
Oh, that's
the king of lover's rock. Yeah. And that's why we have a tribute for him in February during Valentine's.
Oh, you had it in Jamaica?
Yes, in Jamaica we have the yearly tribute during Valentine's. Oh, Red Rose for Gregory. That's what we call it. That's the name of the show.
We need to plan the next one. Next February we'll be doing something a bit big. We'll come together to do that. All right?
Right, no problem.
We'll be looking at that. You started Cool June. What is that about?
We started out Cool June as a booking agent.
Oh, as a booking agent for Gregory?
Yes. Yes. No. Oh. I started that after he passed.
Yeah. Okay. Tell me
not
about
just a freelance booking agent that we promoters overseas would want an act here, and then we would get them for them at a cost, at the percentage. So that's how I started that. And then June, my friend, name is June as well, so we just came together. We had J&J first, and then we said, oh no. And then we came back to Cool June Booking Agent. So we have been together, keeping gigs wherever we can.
I'm just curious. Let's see if I can throw you under the bus. Why cool? Are you saying that both of you are bad girls?
No, no. The cool came from Gregory, the cool ruler. The cool came. You know, he's called a cool ruler, right?
I know, he's called the cool runner. Right. Exactly, I know that.
But then it was cool Jude after.
I just wanted to throw you under the bus. All right. Now, let's take another song from Gregory Isaacs. Yeah. Now, I'm thinking, could we do Stranger in Town or Cool Down the Pace, right, or Objection Overruled?
Right. Some which, of my favorites.
Which of them?
Objective Overruled.
Oh, you love that. Why?
Why do you don't like sing that to me when we.
No. Nah, the memories
you,
are
you know the
now.
Lyrics, right? You know the lyrics.
The memories are coming now. Now you're talking. Tell me about it.
I would always hear mom whenever we have a fuss or anything like that. I would always hear singing that song. Coming in the night, I can hear him just singing that song, coming in, trying to comfort me. So I remember it quite well. I remember when it was written and everything.
All right, let's take this song. This is Objection Overruled. When we come back, I'll be asking you, I'll let you go, but before that, I'll be asking you about royalties. I mean, since he passed, I don't know what it is with, some of the songs, because since he passed, quite a number of his songs are trending, okay?
Right.
Yeah, I don't know what it is with royalties, if you guys are making money from it, but that's when we come back, okay?
Okay.
So let's take this. Classic FM 973. My name is Benji, as Remember the Time, and I have with me Bob Marley's cousin, June Hayles, and Gregory Isaacs' wife, June Isaacs. And we've been talking, all right? Here is Gregory Isaacs, and it is Objection Overruled. Stay with us. We'll be back in a bit. Anna, how you doing?
Anna,
Isaacs tonight, as we, oh man, I'm looking at the lyrics of a song. Please give me a chance so I can make my confession, or do I was wrong? Won't you please overrule your objection and give me one chance so that I can.
Have you ever sing that song to anyone?
I wanted to ask you that. Why was he saying that to you? What happened?
I hear the song over and over. Over and over, it's been sung to me, you know. I love it so bad. I love that lyrics, and it's just a song that is it has so much meaning, different meaning to different ones, and a lot of people can relate to it.
Now, would you consider Gregory Isaacs a lover guy? I mean, how loving was it? I mean, I'm not talking about kids, his relationship with his kids. I'm talking about you as a person.
Okay. Very loving. Very loving. Very. I mean, we were so much in love to the point that we were inseparable.
Mm. Can you tell me some
crazy things? As I said before, anywhere he went, I was there. You wouldn't see one without the other. And
okay, let's see if I can throw you under the bus again. Can you tell me some crazy, the craziest things that both of you have done?
Oh my God. Benji, you're putting me on the spot.
I am.
You're putting me on the spot. I mean, we have had some very good times. Very, very good times. Going out on a ski bike. I mean, on the water. I mean, we have done some extreme things, and I have so many memories, and sometimes I would sit and smile by myself because he was one of the fun-lovingest person I can think of as a Rasta man. Because, you know, people portray Rasta differently, but he was quite calm so and cool, and that's how he got the name Cool Ruler.
Cool,
he was loving. Cool, I got flowers. I mean, he treated me over the top.
Now let's look at the finances. I mean, he made so much money, and then he passed on. He passed. What, you having any issues with royalty? Are you getting paid, you know, after he...
I think I'm getting just paid, yes. Yes. As the head of the estate, I have good lawyers. And all our finances are being protected, right? Yeah. And the estate consists of me and the kids. So, yes, we get all our... I think we are on good levels with collecting royalties worldwide.
Now, one of the things that you... I mean, you said both of you, everywhere he went, you also, you were there with him. I do know that there was a time you met Prince Charles. Mm-hmm. I really want to know what the experience was.
No, that was Judy. That was Judy.
Oh, that was Judy. Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. It was Judy, yeah? Were you performing with Gregory Isaacs on stage? Have you ever performed with him on stage? Do you sing?
No. No, I don't. I mainly stick to the business part. Being his personal assistant and make sure he's paid and all of that.
I just want to tell you that, I mean, congratulations to you. For you to have an artist as big as Gregory Isaacs, and he's doing what he gave us the very best that he has, must have meant that he had a woman at home, with him, who kept his head cool. I mean, if he had been involved with the wrong woman, I don't think he would be this big. So I want to say congratulations to you. It also shows...
Thank you.
Tenacity.
I did my best as a wife and stepmom. I had a few challenges. Well, yes, I had a few challenges, but in the end, I managed to really... play my role.
Exactly. Well. And your role you have played well. But let's get a bit emotional now. Can you take me through the very last 1 week before he passed?
The very last?
Yeah, 1 week before he passed. Maybe a week or two before he passed.
Okay.
What was it like?
I cannot say much about that because we weren't together at that time. We separated a few years before. We live apart a few years, but when he was going to do that surgery in the end, like a few weeks before he passed, he came by and he told me that he was going to do a surgery and he would be okay, and told me a few things business wise not knowing that he knew that he was going and not coming back. You know, he told me a few things personal about the kids, about the estate, about the house and all things like that, personal things. And then he went off to London, and then he called me when he, apparently the doctors told him that he had not much long to go. So he called me back to say he's not doing the surgery anymore, but he's okay. And that was the last conversation we had, really, until he passed off a week or so after.
And then how did you find out that he's passed? How that he passed? How?
he was in England among his kids. Two of his kids reside there, and they called to say he had passed.
And how did you take that?
Really bad, but I wasn't surprised, because a lot of rumors were going around before that he was he wouldn't have much longer to go. So we were just here, you know, just praying, asking God, you know, to just turn that around. But unfortunately, the cancer spread so much. He died from lung cancer. Yeah. And then it wasn't a surprise at all to us anyway. But just the period of time was just quick, from the time we hear to the time he passed.
Well, may his soul rest in peace, perfect peace.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks. Classic FM 97.3. My name is Benji. I've been discussing with Gregory Isaac's wife, June Isaacs. And we've been taking time. We've looked at how it all started, you know, and where we are today. You and June Hayles, I mean, both of you are running the business, the Cool June business.
Yeah.
Now, how's it been like? I mean, you guys are making good money, some cool dollars.
Yes. would have made some better money last year, but the pandemic came in, you know, because we had plans for some shows in Canada with Sanchez and Brazil.
Oh, nice.
And London, you know, just before the pandemic. We had all those plans, but we started promoting as well. But the pandemic, we had to stop.
But,
we have some plans to continue those and others. We're even planning to come to Nigeria.
Exactly.
Sometime soon. Yeah.
I want to say that. I mean, I'm so looking forward to us doing a couple of things here, you know, like we said. All right.
And I must big you up on other disc jock. You are doing well for reggae over there.
Thank you so very much.
Well appreciated. Well appreciated.
Now, you know, there's something I told you earlier on. I'll be looking at the possibility of having you and I have a show on this station on Classic FM. You can present from Jamaica, two of us. All right. I'll see the possibility on that. And then we can start having a show on radio.
I love that. Yeah.
Are you very close to Marcia Griffith?
Not very close, no.
All right. Nice.
But I love her.
You love her?
I love her.
In two weeks, I'll be having on my show, Marcia Griffith.
Okay. Nice.
All right. So let me thank you. I want to thank you so very much for your time. Thank you. I'm sure I must have taken your time.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you so much.
And I will say again, big up to you.
Big up to you.
Classic FM 97.3. Thank you for having me.
Yeah.
I must big up to Billy Bronco too. And Roaring Thunder internationally. International. International promoter in Nigeria. Thanks for keeping the reggae flag hanging high. Thank you very much.
All right, I want to thank you. Thank you so very much. But quickly before you go, any of your kids willing to take over from him? Any of your kids singing?
Yes, you have Kevin Isaacs that is doing well, and you have Ray Isaacs that is doing quite well too, and he's also booked for the festivals in Europe next year. But the others, no.
All right. No. Thank you so very much, June Isaacs. Thank you. I wish you the very best. Okay.
Thank you.
Now we're gonna end. Just help me. I have what song can we end with? Cool Down the Pace. Stranger in Town or Night Nurse?
Night Nurse!
Night Nurse!
Of course.
I'm not surprised at all. Oh, Lord. Thank you very much, June Isaacs.
You're welcome. Yeah? Bye.
I've had June Isaacs on the show, Gregory Isaac's wife. Well, let's check this. This is Mac Nurse, Gregory Isaacs. Stay with me.